Hello, friends of the Northern Entertainment, and welcome to another episode of my Autobahn Police Simulator 2 Let's Play series. We are here this morning, just about, well, it's Tuesday in game, Tuesday 6:13 in the morning, and we are just about to head out. Remember, we still have to deal with this stone thrower dude. So we're gonna be going today. Undercover. Well, not undercover, but unmarked. So that's exactly what we will do. Interestingly enough, the controls are once again not working. I don't know what happened, but it is what it is. So we are available for calls. Ow. And apparently I lost my ability to drive completely. But regardless, hello everybody, welcome. Welcome, welcome. Okay, what is going on with that dude here in front of us? All right. Let's have it. What? Welcome to the Twilight Zone. I just pulled myself over, apparently.
Hello.
What?
Hello.
Is going on here?
Have you taken any drugs?
No, of course not. What are you taking me for?
Well, I would like to see your face, to be honest with you. How about alcohol?
Have you been drinking?
Of course I've not had anything to drink.
License and registration, please.
Show me your license and registration, please. Thank you. I'll have a look.
What the? Spider 2, that's all good, that's all good, that's all good. This is like seriously messed up.
I'll come back to you shortly.
Wow, this is something else. I pulled myself over. It's the same name too. Did you guys notice that? don't even know what to say right now. There's of course nothing wrong with this car because, well, it is I. Brake lights are good. Indicators are good. Let's have a look inside. Okay, first aid kit and warning triangle I'm missing. Lila's lady shoes. Yeah, about that. Check the tires on this one. Okay, so I'm gonna give myself a warning.
Your first aid kit is missing.
Yes, it is.
Embarrassing.
Especially when you pull yourself over.
You don't have an advance warning triangle with you.
Mm-hmm.
I lost it.
Certainly.
The last time I had a breakdown.
I have to give you a warning, but don't let this happen again.
So, yeah, I just pulled myself over. That is the first. That is a first, all right. Wow. All right. Well, let's continue then. Now, I have seen a lot of things before, but this one is new. Okay. Good.
Attention all units.
Okay.
Two cars just came in. At least one of the vehicles has skidded.
Uh-oh.
And is now facing oncoming traffic. There also seems to be an argument between
We're gonna take this one. Two types of collisions, eh? I would really love to change my my status. But I can't. Good. So we're gonna go with the wrong radio status because that's just the way it is now. But since one is facing oncoming traffic, we are going code 3 there, for sure. I tried to do a conventional 190 here on the Autobahn, if we can help it. And we are 4.3 kilometers away at the moment, so traffic is light, traffic is yielding for the most part. So it reminds me a little bit of driving in Fernbus Simulator. Just faster and with more sirens. And less passengers. So I guess it doesn't remind me of Fernbus Simulator at all. And yeah, before you leave me angry comments in the description or in the comment section below that, oh well, why are you driving on this side or on that side? Because they are not getting out of my way otherwise. They just flat, ow, that was my fault. They just stand right where they were. So, 1.8 kilometers. It's really, if you slow down where it's appropriate to slow down, then it's no problem getting there without any accident at all. ...600 meters. ...300 meters. Oh, it looks like I'm gonna have to turn around. Thankfully, they decided to have that crash right on the opposite side here. Right after off-ramp. It's perfect. Now again, I would love to change my radio status, but I can't. I would go to status 4 as soon as I'm at the location. Now we need this and this and this. And status 4, please. Status 4, status 4, status 4, status 4. Come on. It just doesn't let me. Nope. Alright, I guess no status 4 then, I can't help it. Oh boy, look at that. It has all kinds of problems going on.
I'll take care of checking the personal details before you speak to the people. In the meantime, you can take care of something else. I've recorded the personal details. Everything okay so far?
Accident investigation consists of various tasks. Securing the scene of the accident, photographing the scene of the accident, accident sketch, clearance of the wreckage, and dialogue with the parties involved. Not every accident contains all tasks. Accident investigation ends with a final report. Okay. The scene of an accident should always be secured first. For this purpose, you can take the traffic cones out of the trunk of your vehicle and place them in the highlighted locations. You should always speak to the parties involved in the accident. This will describe their view of events and blah 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 blah. Activate the camera by blah 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 blah. Open the accident sketch with each photographed object is identified by an icon for better orientation. Object is already shown on the sketch. The objects need to be both moved and rotated. If an object is placed correctly, it will snap into place and turn green. So, okay, well, actually, this is nice. They made this a little bit more involving than it used to be. I just hope I have traffic cones in this one. Otherwise, I'm gonna be a very sad Alex here right away. Okay, I like this. This is free placement. You just have to be in the general area. Good. So we got that secured and we got a line of traffic here already. Good, good. That's wonderful. Can I take anything else? No, apparently not. Too bad. Okay. Well, let's go ahead here and take some pictures. So this is the red car, apparently. I do not know how in the world you can get a pattern like this. That is beyond me. Absolutely beyond me. No zoom. And they are arguing by the looks of it. Okay, now let's complete the sketch. So we have this vehicle. I'm gonna grab it. Oh, okay, I see. This is on an iPad. Mm-hmm. There. Okay. Ah, I see how this whole scene looks like. So this one would be front facing the there. Then this goes here. Okay, so we got that. Now we're gonna talk with those two gentlemen.
Let's all calm down now.
Yes, let's.
Mr. Meyer, I'd like to talk to you.
All right. Might be good to talk to someone who's not a complete idiot for a change.
Hey.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that, Mr. Meyer. Calm down, okay?
Yeah, got it. I wanted to overtake normally and go back into the outside lane when this fellow put his foot down. I didn't notice until it was too late. He caught me on the rear, and I swerved out of control. You see? I really took a spin.
Did you notice anything mm-hmm. else?
Yes, indeed. The bloke in the other car had been provoking me for several kilometers.
Mm. How did he provoke you?
Every time I overtook him, he veered around and overtook me. I also thought I saw him give me the finger. I don't have to put up with that.
I've heard enough for now. I'm going to talk to the other driver.
Okay, then. He gave him the finger.
Hello, Mr. Caller. May I speak to you, please?
Yes, of course. I'm sure that bloke has told you a whole load of bollocks.
Calm down.
Oh, wow.
I don't want to hear any more disrespectful language.
Uh-huh.
Is that clear?
I'm sorry. It won't happen again.
All right. Now, Tell me, what happened from your point of view?
That bloke over there? Sorry. The driver of the car tried to cut back in front of me really closely, and in the process, he hit my car and swerved out of control.
Did you notice anything else concerning the other vehicle or the accident?
He had been provoking me for a long time. Sometimes he drove right up behind me, flashing his lights. Then he passed me and pulled back in right in front of me. I really can't understand his behavior, as I never did anything to him.
The other driver stated that you accelerated intentionally in order to make it more difficult for him to return to the outside lane. Is that true?
I beg your pardon. Of all the nerve. Just because he can't drive properly, he has to make up a claim like that. I most certainly did not speed up.
And you're standing by your statement?
Oh, yes.
We're done for the time being. I'll speak to the witness and then come back to you.
Okay, we questioned the witness. Now what I want to see is... Okay.
Hello, Mrs. Glockner.
What's going on with you?
First of all, thank you for making yourself available as a witness.
My pleasure. Mm-hmm. When I see hooligans like that on the road...
Hooligans?
I'm happy
to help. Ooh.
Please, go ahead.
I don't like driving on the Autobahn, but if I must, then I mostly stay in the outside lane. Okay. Today, I drove behind the two of them for several kilometers. I could really see that they were getting more and more aggressive. What triggered things, or who provoked who first, I couldn't say. Mm-hmm. Only that the pair of them kept driving more and more wildly.
Mm-hmm.
They kept overtaking one another, and then intentionally cutting right in front of the other.
Okay, I see. Let's get to the actual accident. Can you describe it?
Yes. The dark car had just overtaken the red one again. But this time, he hit him when turning into the lane and swerved out of control.
Did the dark car cut back in too closely?
Yes, indeed. Even more closely than before.
And when the dark car began to overtake, did the red one accelerate?
Yes, it did.
Okay, thank you very much for your statement. You've been very helpful.
All right, so... I would have to guess it's gonna be 50-50.
Well, perhaps that is right. But the other guy...
We'll talk about him in a moment. For now, let's talk about you.
Mm-hmm.
It seems like you are waging some kind of personal war with the driver of the red car.
Mm-hmm.
I've got no sympathy for such things. In the next few days, you're going to receive a letter from the Crown Prosecution Service regarding your reckless behavior on the road and coercion. I hope this will teach you a lesson.
Most certainly. I don't know how things could get so out of control. Somehow, I got carried away.
Apparently so.
Now to you. The witness stated that you put your foot down, which contributed to the accident.
Well, if I did, it was only a little.
You can make a statement to that effect to the Crown Prosecution Service.
Mm-hmm.
You'll also be held accountable for coercion and reckless driving.
I beg your pardon?
The witness observed the little war you were having for several kilometers.
Oh, I don't know why that happened either. That's not my style at all. Can't you look the other way?
No, we certainly can't. Let this be a lesson.
Yeah, no kidding. Oh wow, look at that. And everything is magically disappearing. And the traffic is just completely out of control. Now you don't see that every day. Oh look, we got the next accident right there. Well, I do think, guys, that besides pulling myself over here and now having to deal with that, this is where we're gonna leave off for now. Oh, look at that. We have already 3,000 points. Hopefully, we get another. Sayonara, what are you doing now? Okay. Nope, we're gonna have one more. This bloke there, as they say. And apparently this siren is indeed, or this yelp is indeed, what you usually would hear in a case like this. For once or twice. Oh wow. Why, oh why, do we always end up with at least one truck pulled over just at the end of the episode? Oh well, this is gonna be a quick one. He's gonna get his ticket for reckless, and then we continue our day. At least I didn't pull myself over, so. Yeah.
Hello.
Here's the license and registration, please.
Show me your license and registration, please. Thank you. I'll have a look.
Yeah. This one and this one. And yes, I know. These. That's okay. This is really going to be quick. Driving and resting times. Or hours of service.
Of your driving and resting times?
There you are.
Good.
Everything seems to be okay.
Let me guess, perishable fruits.
Can I see your freight documents, please?
Here's the freight information.
Of course.
Perishable food.
Have you taken any drugs?
Good.
Drugs? Not me.
Have you been drinking?
Well, I must admit, I did have a couple of beers.
All right.
Can't be all that bad, can it?
Then, please, sir.
You'll have to come with me. Please step out of the vehicle.
Well then. This is what happens. Low profile. Yeah, that was definitely not low profile. But this is what happens if you break the law. You end up in the back of a police car. Let that be a lesson, kids. Drinking and driving is bad. And if you drink and drive, then do not almost run into police cars. That's bad practice altogether. But we will end this here for today. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. I certainly did. If you want to leave a comment down in this comment section below, then feel free to do so. Subscribe if you haven't done already. If you like my content, of course. And until next time, this is the Northern Alex signing off.
God bless. We still need volunteers for a large-scale...